morning, everybody. Dave Brown and Corey Macklin here at ringside. We're just about set to go with another big day of USWA Championship Wrestling.
We've got it today, Dave. Eric Embry, Flamboyant Eric Embry, will be here today. The Moondogs and their manager, Richard Lee. I tell you, you'll want to see Richard today. And we've got Jeff Jarrett and the King, Jerry Lawler, teaming up in tag team match. A full day today.
Oh, my goodness. Some action coming up we're going to show you in just a moment. That's almost unbelievable. We'll have that when we return.
You were in Kennett, Missouri.
We had all that wild action we showed everybody last week. And we were talking about that we thought that was one of those things that it just everything got out of hand and then everything was back to normal and sort of normal and wouldn't have that repeated again. Not the case. It was just sort of a continuation of that at the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum just a couple of days later. The Moondogs against Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler. Take a look at this action.
Jarrett off the top rope. top of Jarrett. Lawler with a chain wrapped around his chest. Pounds away on the Moondog. The Moondog firing right back off on top of him. Choking away on the golden boy, Jeff Jarrett.
Here we go again. The action still underway. Wall and Jarrett going after the Moondog, spot and fight. Boy, a wild bout we've got here tonight. Wall and Jarrett came out from the opening building. Jump on the Moondogs, and it's been go for yourself ever since. Lawler's busted open over there. Moondog's fight going after Jeff Jarrett. Working on Jeff. Jeff with the right hand. Catches Lawler. Moondog spot. Working on the king now. He's got that chair all on. And again, he caught him with that chair. Lay Lawler flat out. Jeff Jarrett comes over to help his partner. Moondog nails Jeff in the back with that chair. Oh boy, these guys are outrageous. The Moondog, the USWA champions. Look out. There goes our railing over here. Comes the Moondog over here. Oh, boy. Big Jeff up. Throws him down on that railing over here.
Jarrett throwing right down on top of the security railing. Moondog spot working Lawler over with a trash can. He picks the king up. Fires away on him. Has the king busted open. Jarrett fires right back off. On spot. Spike with Lawler. Outside the ring. Jarrett with a metal chair. Comes down off the ring, right down on top of Spot's head. Jarrett wraps the chain around the fist. Fires right off on him. Action everywhere. There isn't anything they can get their hands on. Jarrett off the rope, off the ring again with a metal chair. Right down on top of Spot. Lawler up in the ring with Moondog Spike. Lawler tossed into the timekeeper's table head first. The Moondog. International Roughnecks choking away on the king with a metal chair. Jarrett thrown over the metal security railing outside on the floor.
Boy, he threw Jeff that time. Picked him up and threw him right over that railing. Jeff had the Moondog. Was going to open it to that rail. He reversed Jeff. Hey, look out. Chair over there. Moondog grabs that chair and nails Lawler with it. Got that chair in the ring now, setting it up on the rope. Grab Lawler, picks him up. Into that chair that has Moondogs all over it. Moondog spike. Choking Lawler now. Richard Lee at ringside blowing that silly whistle. Oh, Jeff! Came off the rope down to Moondog, but the Moondog caught it back again. Boy, this is a wild bout. Lawler and Jarrett versus the Moondog. Mid-South Coliseum, boy, has been turned over. Fans getting behind Lawler now. King back up on his feet. Right hand down by Jeff.
Got a lot of action coming up right here today, but I tell you, that war started in Kennett, continued at the Coliseum, is going to continue tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum. Tonight, the Moondogs against Jerry Lawler and Jeff Jarrett. This time, though, no stopping the match, no disqualification. Well, I tell you, we've had all kind of action here in the last few weeks around here. One, it had that strap battle royal, which was going on. Here are just some of the highlights of that one right now.
Kyle Pritchett fighting back now. Whoa, one for Tony Anthony. Tucked that strap from Embry. Came back on there. Legendary Embry now. He's eliminated from the elimination strap battle. Tom Pritchard, Dirty White Boy, Tony Anthony, Eric Embry, and Tony Falk. Look at there. Embry came from behind and kicked Pritchard in the back and eliminated Falk and Pritchard. So it's Eric Embry and Dirty White Boy, Tony Anthony, last two remaining in the elimination strap battle. Oh, what a wild one. Straps going everywhere. Look at Embry. Pulled his strap down and realized what he was doing. Said, hey, I'm not going to give him any more coverage in there. Pull his straps back up and try to keep him gone from Tony Anthony. Anthony's swinging that though, too.
Anthony, cat of nine tails, right a light into Eric Embry. Embry, not too sure about going in after Anthony. Belts fly, leather straps fly. Embry, best keep his eye on the Dirty White Boy.
trying to come up with a way to get in to one another. Oh, look at that. Anthony. Whoa, going in. And now he tails right across the back. Another flamboyant one. Tony Anthony has one up on Eric Embry. Couple of words from Tony Anthony. Embry being stalked by the dirty white boy. Oh, Tony Anthony goes in, grabs a strap, but Embry rakes him across the eye. Takes the buckle to that belt and just pops him right at the top of the head. Fires him into the ropes. Embry coming in, goes to strap him. Tony Anthony able to clothesline him. Put that count of nine tails. Anthony pounding away with the count of nine tails across the back of Embry.
Yeah, Dave, he stopped Embry with a big clothesline and came back lashing him. Working on Eric Embry now. Every frame of Rattle telling him to break the hold in. Tony Anthony and Eric Embry. Last two in the elimination strap battle. Well, he's got Embry well completely out now.
Tony Anthony has him backed into the corner. Embry wanting a way out of there and quick. Embry goes downstairs to the midsection. Embry with that strap right across the back of Tony Anthony. Anthony turns around, yells at him, has that adrenaline pump. Up goes Embry's belt. Tony Anthony wearing Embry out with the strap. Has him tied up in the rope. Look out, Eric Embry. Tony Anthony pounded away on him. CJ up on the ring apron. Looking at Tony. Oh, man. CJ just threw something in the eyes of Tony Anthony. Eric Embry out of the ropes, picks up a strap, picks up both straps, starts whipping away on Tony Anthony. Pounding on him. There goes Anthony out of here. That's going to be it. The winner of the match, Eric Embry. Coming out victorious in the strap match, the flamboyant Eric Embry. Put Tony Anthony out of here. CJ outside the ring. Got a hold of Anthony with something in his eyes. But Anthony paying her back for it. Has that count of nine tail. Wearing CJ out. Chasing her around the ring. Things are over. Starts whipping away with the count of nine tail.
Some leaks, boy, did she take some leaks from dirty white boy Tony Anthony, but Embry slowed him down. Now Embry's got him in the ring. Threw Tony back in, lashed him with that belt again. Boy, he's got Tony in bad shape now. The battle all is over. He's got Tony in between those ropes. Got him hung up. Oh, boy, he's lashing Tony Anthony, dirty white boy. Embry, boy, I tell you, now he's giving the strap to CJ. Oh, Embry just nails referee Frank Morrell. He's going to be fined for that. That's $1,000 for him. CJ, lashing dirty white boy, Tony Anthony. Boy, she lashing Anthony. Hey, look at that. Here's Tom Pritchard by Sawyer. Through the ring. There goes Embry and CJ now. Boy, Eric Embry grabbed dirty white boy, Tony Anthony, threw him in the ring and had him hanging in between those two ropes. And slash dirty white boy. Tony Anthony, what a wild elimination strap battle war.
Tony Anthony said it was one of the most embarrassing moments of his life.
One of the most embarrassing day, Brown. Hey, white boy, how's it feel to get whooped by a woman, man? How's it feel, white boy? One of the most embarrassing moments, Dave Brown. That had to be the most embarrassing time of your life, dirty white boy. But you know what just boggles my mind? What just boggles my mind, Tony Anthony, is you went to Eddie Merlin and you wanted another match. Well, why, white boy? Because you know what's going to happen? You know what's going to happen, Dave Brown? You know what's going to happen? Have I ever lied to you? Have I ever come out here and said I was going to do something and not do it? One time. Have I ever? No, I ain't, man. You know what's going to happen, white boy? This lovely looking lady standing beside me is going to whelp you again. Like, well, a whole lot worse than last time, because evidently that didn't get it done. That didn't make you get on your knees and crawl back to the dressing room like the egg-sucking dog you are, man. So this time, white boy, she's gonna whip you till you bleed, man. She's gonna keep wearing that back out. You understand what I'm saying? You understand what I'm saying? Hey, white boy, you've made the biggest mistake of your life, man.
Eric Embry, the flamboyant one, with CJ at his side. Got a match coming up right now with Embry. He heads to the ring. Standing up there right now, Bart Sawyer. We're just about set to go. We got a one fall, 15-minute time limit match scheduled here. Referee Paul Neighbors awaits as Eric Embry now is up on the apron. Well, you know, he's not focusing on this match at all. He's focusing on the dirty white boy, Tony Anthony.
Yeah, but he's better. Bart Sawyer's a tough opponent for him, too. We're underway. Eric Embry, Bart Sawyer. Whoa, Embry. Swung after the Bart man. Bart ducked. Ducked that punch from Embry. Sawyer throws Embry across the ring. Well, Embry's already upset.
Yeah, he is upset. Yeah. I think, you know, he stepped in there, as we said, he wasn't really focusing much on Bart Sawyer. Sawyer's a former half of world tag team champions. You don't overlook an opponent like that.
Sawyer! Oh, reversal, reversal again. Embry into the turnbuckle. Embry caught him with a foot throw. Went into the turnbuckle. Sawyer went after him, and Embry caught him with a big foot. Sawyer goes down. Picks him up now. Call it for CJ up on the ring apron.
She steps in.
Hey, yeah, she's in the ring then.
That's a disqualification,
oh, yeah. Referee Paul Neighbors says ring it. CJ lashing Bart Sawyer. She's in the ring. I don't know what in the world she's doing up there. She climbs in the ring, lashing Bart Sawyer. Hey, come on, Eric.
That's what's going to happen to white boy. That's what's going to happen to white boy.
Look at that.
That's bad.
Let's get out of this. Let's go to break. Remember the actions tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum, and Eric Embry has to face Dirty White Boy in the match there, and the war continues. The Moondogs against Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler tonight. You know, we got a lot of calls and letters, too, from folks saying, hey, how do I get into wrestling and all that sort of stuff? And, you know, I've had some high school background or whatever. Well, if you're interested, take a look at this.
The world-renowned USWA Wrestling Academy comes to Nashville, Tennessee. The wrestling school that has produced legendary professional wrestlers. Jerry the King Lawler, Tommy Wildfire Rich, Huckstep Eddie Gilbert, The Rock and Roll Express, Jeff Jarrett, and more. Now you can attend the USWA Wrestling Academy at Fitness Trainers in Nashville and be trained by the best. Send for your application today to USWA Wrestling Academy, P.O. Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077. Be sure to enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope. Learn to wrestle from the best. The USWA Wrestling Academy.
Right now, here's Tony Falk along with Miss Jennifer, who has made an appearance here today. And you want to talk about this match coming up, I understand.
Well, listen, I want you to get a good look. This lady right here is the best-looking lady that's ever been out here on the USWA program. She's the most intelligent lady by far, but that's not why I fell in love with this young lady. You know, if you're going to be married to a professional wrestler, one thing a woman's got to be is she's got to be tough. Well, I found out that this young lady right here is just as tough as they come. And as far as I'm concerned, she can get in that match and beat everyone they want to put her up against.
So you consider her the favorite in the Battle Royal then, huh?
That's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Hey, Eric Embry here with CJ.
You're kind of overstepping your boundaries a little bit. I understand you think she's the best looking girl. I understand you think she's the most intelligent. And to you, and to him, Dave, she probably is pretty tough. But, hey, you're talking to the whole wide world out there, and everybody knows that I got the loveliest lady on the face of God's green earth today. And this girl's tough, too. Now, hey, we're buddies, but I'm going to tell you what's going to happen in that battle royal. She's going to whoop her just like she whooped white boy, Tony.
Now, look, Eric, that's your opinion, but my opinion is Miss Jennifer's the tougher.
No. Dude, that's the whole world out there, man. You can't lie to that whole world.
Wait, headed this way. Headed this way right now. Dr. Tom Pitchett and Miss Texas. Come on over, Tom.
I heard a lot of talk about how pretty you two girls are. Well, I'll say this, y'all. You two are real pretty. You're pretty ugly to me, man.
Hold on. Let me tell both of y'all, bleach blonde bimbo something. I'm the toughest woman around here, honey. You don't think so? You better ask somebody.
Miss Texas. All right, well, we...
You forgot where I found you on Harry Hines Boulevard in Dallas, Texas. I know how to...
Wait a minute. Here come Bull Payne and Samantha headed this way.
Stop the presses and shut your holes. Because we were sitting in Dallas, Texas last night, and we heard that there's some women flapping their jaws down in Memphis, Tennessee, saying how tough they are. Well, you know it, you geeks know it, and we know it, that Samantha Payne is the toughest girl to ever put on a pair of wrestling boots.
Let me tell you something, you little malnourished chicken. Oh, you heard me, malnourished chicken, and I'll pluck all you little idiots, Paul, because I can beat every woman here if I can even call you a woman, and you string me need to buy a ticket and sit down.
I don't get too close to her. Her stay your light hit my leg off.
Hey, while they're arguing, here comes the dirty white boy, Tony Anthony, headed this way. Tony.
Hussy. And let me tell you something, you fat, disgusting piece of garbage, and you too. Oh, what are you gonna do, jump on me? I'll beat your stinking brains out whether you like it or not. And let me tell you something. Nobody humiliates me like that and gets away with it. Shut up, punk! Now, you want to talk about having the prettiest, the meanest, and the nastiest women around? Well, Jack, I've got the meanest, the most manipulating woman in the world, and I'm talking about the dirty white girl! Get out of here! Whether you like it or not!
Here she is. Here comes the dirty white girl. Oh, look out, look out, look out, look out. Whoa! Going after CJ immediately. Dirty white girl after CJ. Eric Embry's got her. There they go. Dirty white boy and dirty white girl cleared this area quickly.
Let me tell you something, you peroxide princess. You lay a finger on this man again, and I will slap you into your next lifetime and make you like it.
And you heard that right there, Kimberly. You big, disgusting slob. You whipped me, and you had that tramp whip me. Well, now, baby, it looks like it's a little even. Now, Embry, if that little nothing happening tramp steps in the ring, I've got my equalizer to take care of her. And, Embry, what are you going to do when it's just me and you? Eyeball to eyeball. Huh? Fist to fist, toe to toe, nose to nose. I don't think you're a man enough to take me out. Well, we're going to find out. Let's rock, white girl.
Don't miss this one. It's coming up back here in just a moment. Tell you what, just about every week at this time, for years we have said Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. It's not Monday night this time around. It is...
Tonight. That's right. Tonight.
7:30 is when it's going to be, and this is a great opportunity. It's being on Saturday night. No school day tomorrow and all that, so
no
the kids don't have to get up
yeah.
at 5:30 or 6 o'clock maybe, and it's great for folks from around the territory. Maybe kind of gives everyone an opportunity to drive on down to the Mid-South Coliseum and be right there for ringside action.
Oh, yeah.
And what a card we've got coming up here tonight. Parking is free, by the way, tonight. And to start with, seven-match tournament. Now, You remember a few weeks ago, we were talking about the situation with getting a world title match, and no longer were just the top 10 rankings acceptable due to all sorts of situations. So this is going to be a tournament, and the winner of it will get a world championship match against the champion, which is currently Kamala. Opening round, here's the way it's going to stack up right here.
Opening round, Coco Ware, Doug Masters, Robert Fuller, and Bullpen all be in the same bracket. Second bracket will be Brian Christopher, Bart Sawyer, Tony Falk, Tom Pritchard. Of course, the winners of those brackets will advance to the semifinal round.
That's correct. Very good there. And as you saw all of that go down, you got the opening round, the semifinal round, and then the final round with the eventual winner getting the shot at the world title currently held by Kamala. But that tournament, you know, many nights, you know, you have a tournament this big with all those names, and that would be a pretty full night of action.
Oh, but yeah.
That's just the beginning
tonight.
That's
just the opening bout.
Look at this, the all-girl battle royal. You saw how they were going out here just a few minutes ago as they were all insulting each other and all of that sort of thing. Get ready at the Mid-South Coliseum tonight. Miss Texas, CJ, Samantha, Jennifer, and the Dirty White Girl, all of them, in the ring in a battle royal coming up tonight.
Wow. Then, Southern title bout, a lot of heat in this one. Eric Embry and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. Now, it says on the screen there, Dave, Eric Embry with CJ, but don't forget about Dirty White Girl with Dirty White Boy.
Yeah, I'm sure she is going to be at ringside now with Tony Anthony. A little
That's
bit of an equalizer there, and this should make for some kind of match. And remember, Southern title is on the line, but that's not all. Main event of the night. The war. Boy, it's hard to say too much about this one, and really you don't need to say too much about this one. If you saw that video at the beginning of the program, you know what's been going on, beginning in Kennett, Missouri, continuing at the Mid-South Coliseum, and the war will continue tonight. This time around, unlike last time, no stopping the match and no disqualification. The Moondogs, the International Roughnecks with Richard Lee, who is a bit worse for the wear.
Yeah,
we'll say more about that later on. He will be at ringside, I guess, tonight. Well, I'm sure he'll be there tonight against Lawler and Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett, Jerry Lawler, going against the Moondog, the incredible, incredible battles that these guys have had.
I mean, tough bouts. I was just sitting at ringside last week, and boy, the rail is gone, the table is gone, and when you look up, you almost, you do good to have a chair and a microphone.
They consider everything a weapon ringside there,
gone.
So get ready, it's tonight. It's 7:30 at the Mid-South Coliseum. Great Saturday night action coming up. Oh, and don't forget, there's a coupon in the commercial appeal in the Airport Toyota ad.
There it is.
You bring the coupon, you must bring it with you, but bring the coupon and it gives you $1 off general admission. Again, 7:30 tonight, parking is free at the Mid-South Coliseum for this tremendous night of action coming up. We'll be back here. We've got the Moondogs coming in shortly in just a moment. Well, I think Eddie Marlin's finally got a wrestler big enough, anyway, to stand up to the Moondogs for the match here on TV today. Freezer Thompson, the big guy from Arkansas, is going to be coming in. Here come the Moondogs right here, and they are led by a somewhat different-looking Richard Lee this time around. He's not blowing the whistle. He does have that chair in his hand. As he steps up this way, maybe for a comment or two, and maybe we can just show everybody how you ended up with all these bandages here. Right here, going back to the Mid-South Coliseum. And there it is right there. Painful to watch, I know, but there it was again, Richard Lee.
Hey, Brad, look at me. Hey, Lola, I didn't do anything to you. I didn't do anything to you. And I saw the fire coming and I saw my last face in front of my face and I thought, why did he do this to me? He permanently disfigured my face. I haven't done anything. I can't even control my dogs anymore. Jerry Lawler, if you want some fight, I got fight left in me. And my dogs have fight left in them. Watch him. Watch him, and this is gonna be you. He tried to kill me.
Richard Lee, mighty unhappy with the situation. His Moondogs have stepped into the ring.
And they are attacking right now, Freezer Thompson and Dazzler Hayes. Corey, they didn't even really give the kids much of a chance. I don't even see Thompson. Where is he? They throw him out of there?
I didn't get a chance to see him. I tell you, the Moondogs are over here running all after me and everything. Now, they got Dazzler for the cover. Now, that's a three count now. That's it. One, two, three. Now, Richard, now take him out of here. Now, they want him about.
That's it, Richard. Get him out of here.
Now, that's it.
Jerry Lawler. Jim Jarrett. If I ever get my hands on you, you're gonna look like I do right now. I'm gonna see Jarrett in your permanently disfigured the same way I am.
Richard Lee. Oh, look out. Freezer falling back this way. Oh, my goodness. The Moondogs picked up that chair. Hammer. Oh, he got him right in the head. Dazzler Hayes hit in the head by that folding metal chair.
Richard Lee is upset. He's upset. And the Moondogs are upset, too. But boy, I tell you, that's enough of this stuff now. They won the bout. Get him out of here, would you, Richard? Now, come on, man.
Referee Frank Morrell is talking to Richard Lee, trying to get him to get him out of here. Corey, I don't know if you could hear him or not. The Moondogs were chasing you over here, but Richard Lee said he wasn't sure he could control the Moondogs anymore.
Look out. Here they come.
Look out.
Watch out, Dave. Watch out over there.
Richard, it's blow the whistle. They beat up on...
Blow the whistle, Dave Brent. It hurts. I can't blow the whistle. Jerry Lawler is dead, Jerry. This is gonna be you right here. This is gonna be you. If I ever get my hands on you or my tongue, I'm gonna disfigure you too.
These guys are sick. They're sick, I tell you. The Moondogs.
Here's Eddie Marlin. Maybe he can convince Richard Lee to get him out of here. Frank Morrell is trying. There they go with a desk, carrying the desk up and picking up chairs. Oh, look out. Watch him, Eddie. Here comes the other one. Watch him.
Oh, boy. There goes our desk, Dave. There goes again. Boy.
Richard Lee refusing to control the Moondogs. That's what it is.
Hey, come on now.
Now he's got the belts. Maybe he's going to call them off
Get
now.
Get him back, Richard. Get him back over there.
Richard Lee picked up the belts, and he picked up one of those big bones. Come on. Richard Lee now telling him to head out of the area, back to the dressing room. That does prove one thing. He can control them when he wants to. There they go. We'll take a break. We'll clean up and be right back. Corey's going to cover the out-of-town action coming up, but Buddy Wayne, you've got some action, and you already had some action one time,
yes,
right?
Yes, we have. In Kennett, Missouri, we're going to have matches back in there Friday night. It's going to be at the American Legion Building. Corey was there 2 weeks ago when we was there. Wildest matches I have ever seen
Incredible.
In my life anywhere. And we're going back in there the 31st. Corey was up there with us last week or 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
We're going to have all the top stars. We have got two special matches the fans do not want to miss. The advance tickets are on sale right now. It's Shoney's Pit Stop. Jerry and Helen Shoney's got tickets there right now. They buy them now. They'll save $1 on their ticket.
And in the ring this time, right?
And it will be in the ring this time. It will be a special match. Everything will be in the ring on it this time.
Very good. Thank you, buddy. That's coming up in Kennett, Missouri. Corey will cover that again in just a moment to talk about all the action coming up. Corey.
Okay. Thank you, Dave. That's right. Kennett, Missouri coming up on the 31st. That's coming Friday night. We're back in Kennett and USWA Wrestling on tour. Sunday, February 2nd, we'll be in Jonesboro, Arkansas, USWA Championship Wrestling in Jonesboro. We got a special $1 off all tickets. That's advanced tickets and tickets that are purchased at the door at the Earl Bell Community Center. Jonesboro, Sunday, February 2nd, next Sunday, 8 o'clock p.m. Excuse me, Sunday, Yeah, that is next Sunday. Yeah, 8 o'clock in Jonesboro, Arkansas. The King will be there, Jeff Jarrett. A lot of people lined up for Jonesboro. Corinth, Mississippi coming up Friday night, February 21st. Dyersburg, Tennessee coming up Friday, February 28th. And Huntington, Tennessee. Batesville, Mississippi. Ripley, Tennessee. USWA Wrestling coming to Ripley. And Ripley, Mississippi. Huntington, Tennessee there coming up Thursday on March 5th. And that's all of the USWA Wrestling on tour, all the top stars in all of those cities. And as time goes, we'll keep you informed of where we'll be and what we'll be doing.
All right, very good. I want to get some clarification, and we'll fill you in just a few minutes. I believe the Jonesboro Wrestling actually should be on Saturday night, which is February the 2nd, but we'll check on that. We'll get back to you on it a little bit later on. It is big action, I can tell you for sure. It's big action coming up tonight at the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum, the war. The Jonesboro is Sunday, I'm told. Okay, Sunday, that would be February 3rd then. Sunday, February 3rd in Jonesboro, Arkansas. We have this action coming up with the Moondogs, Lawler, and Jarrett tonight. No stopping the match, no disqualification. Also, all seven of the women are going to be in that Battle Royal tonight. Big action coming up.
February 2nd, Guy Coffey.
Sunday the 2nd. All right, we're sure about that.
Sunday the 2nd now.
Okay, very good.
Good deal.
I guess we have it straight now. We'll be back. We'll be back with more action coming up for you from right here in just a moment. It's the Ninja and the very large Mephisto, but coming this way, there they are, the King, Jerry Lawler, and Jeff Jarrett. What a team they have become here. They've been battling the Moondogs. They've been taking on anybody that wanted to wrestle them in a match. And today they're going to get the Ninja and Mephisto. Referee says, we're ready, ring the bell. Jeff Jarrett still has on his warm-up jacket, but referee says, let's go. So the bell has sounded. Just as soon as the referee gives the signal that he's ready, then this match is underway. And here is Corey Macklin. It ought to be a good one.
Thank you, Dave Brown. We are ready. The King, Jerry Lawler, Jeff Jarrett. Gets Mephisto and the Ninja.
Lawler serving notice right off the bat. I'm going to try to take those masks off if I can.
Yeah, he saw the mask. Sure, he's going to go after him, too. Jarrett takes the Ninja. Slings him right across the ring. Ninja has on that black outfit with those, get a look at those shoes he has on there. Whoa, Ninja thrown into that turnbuckle by Jeff Jarrett. Jeff into the ropes now. Big backdrop on the Ninja. Takes him down. Lawler. Gets a little extra help in for Jeff, and the Ninja finds himself down on the mat. King picks him up. Body slam on Ninja. Takes the Ninja into the ropes. Back drop on the Ninja again. Tag on Jeff Jarrett. Ninja goes over and tags his partner, Mephisto. First look at him. He's a big guy, too, boy.
He's very tall, and those boots, they look like they're about size 22s.
Yeah. Boy, he is a big guy. Mephisto and Jeff Jarrett standing in the middle of the ring. Jeff trying to figure out how he's going to go after this big guy. Struggling with Mephisto. Oh, boy. Guy's strong, too. Takes Jeff over into the turnbuckle. Referee Frank Morrell trying to get him off. Has to go through that and break Mephisto off. And Jeff Jarrett finally breaks the cover there.
This team of Lawler and Jarrett, boy, they have really put it together in a very short period of time.
They are a good-looking team. They are.
Jeff stalking Mephisto.
Yeah. Boy, that was a power move by Jeff, wasn't it? Catching Mephisto, throws him into the turnbuckle. In the corner of Spartan of the King, Jerry Lawler in the ring now. Lawler and Jerry take Mephisto into the ropes. Whoa, double right hand on Mephisto. Lawler. Picks him up now. Got Mephisto. Oh, DDT. Follows with a big right hand. Tags on his partner, Jeff Jarrett.
Jeff checking with the fans. And what about the fist? They said, yeah, hit him.
There goes Mephisto out on the floor now, out on the concrete floor. Jeff,
look out.
Him up. Look out. Yep. Our desk, I tell you, is about gone. Jeff over here. All right.
Jeff said if they want Moondogs type action, they can get it from us, too. And he's proving it right now. Look at that. All of them in the ring.
Lawler catches the ninja there. Big suplex on Mephisto. Lawler going after the ninja over here. Ninja struggling, trying to save his face there. Lawler almost unstripped him. Mephisto runs right into the big camera over there.
Mephisto and the ninja looked like they were going to leave the area right there. Referee's tolling the count. They've got a count of 10 to get back in there, and they're going to make it. Mephisto is back in the ring.
Mephisto and Jeff Jarrett in the middle of the ring now. Dangle it up. Jeff grabs Mephisto into the ropes now. Big elbow on Mephisto. Takes him down. Jeff Jarrett says if these guys want the kind of action the Moondogs give him, he's ready for it, he said. Throws Mephisto into that turnbuckle now.
Crowd chanting, we want the mask. We want the mask. Lawler said he's going to try to take them off.
Lawler comes down. Oh, Mephisto flips him over now. Going after that mask. Mephisto trying to hang on to it. Oh, look at Ninja climbing up. Whoa! Whoa! Ninja climbed over that top rope trying to save his partner's mask. Lawler nailed him right outside of the ring, too.
Lawler's about half got that mask off of Mephisto.
He's about got it. Jeff comes in with a big right hand on Mephisto. Clothesline brings him down. Follows with an elbow. Another elbow on Mephisto. Working the big man over now. Tags on his partner, Ninja.
Ninja with a bow to Jeff Jarrett.
Working on that arm of the ninja. Twisting that arm, big jam out.
Ooh. Hey, when Jeff gets through with him, he may not be bowing. He may be crawling back to the corner, though.
Ninja finally gets back over to that corner, tags on his partner, Mephisto. Jeff catches him with a big foot. Takes him into the ropes now. Big drop kick. Boy, did he almost take his head off. What a drop kick by Jarrett. Lawler comes down, a big right hand. Pin cover, two, three.
He got it.
What a good-looking team. Lawler and Jarrett get the win.
Yes, indeed. Lawler and Jeff Jarrett with a convincing victory here over this team of Mephisto and the Ninja. That's the action in this one, the victory for Jeff and Jerry. Let's take a break. We'll be back. We'll try to talk to them a little bit later on. Oh, boy. Some kind of action coming up. By the way, one more time, it was my mistake there. Jonesboro Wrestling is going to be Sunday, February 2nd, next Sunday at 8 o'clock at night. Now, let's take a look at the action coming up tonight. Tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum, 7:30. Parking is free out there.
Oh,
we begin with a seven-match tournament. The winner of the tournament will get a shot at Kamala's World Heavyweight title. Here is the opening round right here. Coco Ware, the Birdman, we'll be going against Doug Masters.
That's a good opener.
It sure
good opening bout.
A couple of good wrestlers there will be going at each other. But then after that, in the next one, it's going to be Bull Payne on the left there going against the Tennessee stud, Robert Fuller. Next one, It'll be Bart Sawyer going against Brian Christopher.
That'll be a good single bout, too.
Should indeed.
That'll be interesting, yeah.
Brian Christopher trying to work his way up as quickly as possible. It's a contender. He has said he wants to wrestle as a single. Well, he's got his chance right here.
His hands full, too.
Going against Bart Sawyer. Then it's going to be Tony Falk going against Dr. Tom Pritchard. The winner of the opening round matches will, the winners, will advance to a semifinal round, and then from the semifinals, the final round, and the winner gets a shot at the world heavyweight title. The all-girl battle royal coming up after that. In the ring, you're going to have Miss Texas, CJ, Samantha, Jennifer, Dirty White Girl. This one is going to be wild. You want to see it.
Yes, sir.
The all-girl battle royal tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum. And then after that one, the Southern title is on the line.
Eric Embry with CJ against Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. A lot of heat in this one, Dave. They insulted Dirty White Boy last week with CJ strapping him all with a lot of licks in there. Got a few licks, but Dirty White Girl will be in this corner tonight.
That's true. That could make a lot of difference right there. Let me tell you what a match that is with the Southern title hanging in the balance. And then the war, the main event. No stopping the match this time around. No disqualification. We're talking about the Moondogs going against Jerry Lawler and Jeff Jarrett.
Richard
Lawler
Lee.
And Jarrett, they have been focusing on these guys for a couple of weeks after that event, which really began in Kennett, Missouri, 10 days ago or so. Continued at the Coliseum. Richard Lee got the worst of it last week. Yeah, he's going to be there all bandaged up, I'm sure. Right here, right now, you got Jeff Jarrett and the King himself. King has a crown in hand. I want to get him over here and talk to him just a minute about this action coming up. They had a great victory here today, and Jeff said you want to if the Moondogs want to rumble, they can do it too. And Jeff, I think you proved that in that match here this afternoon.
Yeah, sure did. You know, Dave, looks like you got your table messed up out here. Mm-hmm. It looks like there's been chairs thrown everywhere around. Everything seems to be a little messed up. Well, I'd like to tell the people out there, and I especially like to tell the Moondogs a little something. You know, everybody knows. When you go to a pet store and you look in the cages and there's a bunch of 7 or 8 different kinds of dogs and you finally find the one that you like and you want to pick it out and you take it home and as soon as you get it home, you play with it and everything, and then for the next year or two, if you let that dog do whatever he pleases, he messes up everything. He messes up all over the house. He tears up the carpet. He chews up everything in sight. Yeah, that's exactly right. Chews up everything. But what you've got to do is you've got to take that little puppy, those little dogs, and you got to take them to obedience school.
That's right.
And as soon as they do something wrong, you got to smack them on the nose, and you got to smack them upside the head, and you got to put them on the butt and tell them no. Well, Moondogs, that's exactly what's going to happen to you. It's time to go to school tonight. That's exactly right. Because tonight, there's no stopping, there's no disqualification, it's just going to be, we've done taking care of Richard Lee. It's just going to be the King and Jeff Jarrett against the Moondogs, and boys, it's obedience time, that's all I've got to say. You know, I got to admit, for weeks and weeks, I'd be wrestling against Kamala, or I'd be wrestling against this guy or that guy, and I stood in the back. And I just sort of watch with a little bit of envy as Jeff and Robert Fuller would go out and have those matches with the Moondogs. Because you see what you saw earlier in this show, when you saw about 15 solid minutes of chairs getting busted over heads, of guys getting their faces run through fences, of everything but the kitchen sink, and sometimes the kitchen sink getting thrown in the ring. That right there is the King's kind of match. That's what I cut my teeth on. That's what I love. And when I'd watch Jeff and Robert get to go out there, I got to tell you, I was a little bit jealous. Well, now, baby, now I'm right in the middle of it. And that is right where I want to be, Moondogs. And tonight, you're right, I am excited because it is just a few short hours from right now. We're going to head right over to that Mid-South Coliseum. And Moondogs, I don't know, you can't read, but maybe somebody would tell you that on that screen down there at the bottom, it said no stopping. It said no disqualification. There must be a winner.
That's exactly
and
right.
And tonight, boys, if you thought what we did last week, and if you thought what happened to your precious little Richard Lee was something, like Jeff said, it's time to go to school tonight. It's time for the dogs to go to obedience school. It's time for the dogs to learn that you're supposed to lay at our feet and you're supposed to lick our feet. And before we get through with you, that's what you're going to be doing. Do you understand that, dogs? Tonight at the Coliseum, we are going to beat you like the dogs that you are.
That's right, Jerry. If I can say one more thing, and I want to tell you this, Richard Lee. A good friend of ours, Jackie Fargo, used to say, if you want to come down and see a wrestling match tonight, don't show up, because Moondogs and Richard Lee, you're going to go to a beating school, and that's a promise from Jeff Jarrett and the King.
7:30 tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum.
Well, again, another one of those wild days of USWA wrestling action. We had Embry in here against Bart Sawyer. You know, that match ended up disqualification there. I don't know that we really talked too much about what happened, but it was disqualification when he called CJ into the ring.
Yeah, CJ stepped in the ring and got the strap and all and was lashing Bart Sawyer. But I tell you, it could have been a good bout, but Embry called CJ in the ring, but tonight.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
we'll see.
Yeah, that's going to be a different situation there, no doubt about it. Moondogs in here, of course, with they destroy our desk. I don't know what we're going to.
We're going to need a new desk.
Yeah, we're going to visit a furniture store here before too long and come up with a new desk, maybe 8 or 10 of them if the Moondogs are going to be around here, because they just seem bent on tearing these things to pieces here, and they have done a very good job of it. They actually got the victory today over Freezer Thompson and Dazzler Hayes. Freezer, the big guy, they took him out of it early.
Yeah.
And then Jarrett and Lawler in here. Boy, they look good.
Good-looking team.
Got the win over Mephisto and Ninja. The war is going to continue, though. The Moondogs against Jarrett and Lawler. And that action, remember, it's tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum. Parking is free out there. That'll be the main event. There's a big tournament. The winner of the tournament gets a world title shot. The All-Girls Battle Royal. They stand back from one, too, huh?
Yeah, all of them will be in there. That's going to be a wild one. Now, Richard Lee will be out there tonight with that whistle. I don't know if he'll get a chance to blow it.
I don't know. He said today that he was not able to blow the whistle. He was telling me all that sob story.
Oh, yeah.
He had the bandages on. I'm sure he needed the bandages because, as you've seen a couple of times here today, Lawler hit him right full in the face with fire. But he did prove, and I talked about this earlier, that he can control the Moondogs when he wants to. So he has to shoulder a lot of the blame for what the Moondogs do out here. Tell you what we're going to do right now. We are going to leave you today with some of the highlights of that match, Jarrett and Lawler against the Moondogs. As we said, it began in Kennett, Missouri, and it continued last week at the Mid-South Coliseum, and it will continue tonight at 7:30. That's when it begins out there. And take a look. Just what you may be in for tonight at the Mid-South Coliseum. Watch this right here.
Richard Lee around ringside. Jarrett tackles Richard Lee. The Moondogs grabs the metal railing. Puts right on top of Jarrett. Lawler with a chain wrapped around his chest. Pounds away on the Moondog. The Moondog firing right back off on top of him. Choking away on the golden boy, Jeff Jarrett.
Here we go again. The action still underway. Wall and Jarrett going after the Moondogs, spot and fight. Boy, a wild bout we've got here tonight. Wall and Jarrett came out from the opening building. Jump on the Moondogs, and it's been go for yourself ever since. Lawler's busted open over there. Moondog's fight going after Jeff Jarrett. Working on Jeff. Jeff with the right hand on Spike now. Working back on Spike. Takes him with him into the woods now. Oh, leg foot by the Moondog. He's got that chain that Jeff had earlier. Look out! Moondog catches Lawler right in the midsection with that chair. Right upside of the head with it, he catches Lawler. Moondog spot. the game now. He's got that chair all on. And again, he caught him with that chair. Lay Lawler flat out. Jeff Jarrett comes over to help his partner. Mondo nails Jeff in the back with that chair. Oh, boy, these guys are outrageous. The Moondogs, the USWA champions. Look out. There goes our railing over here. Comes the Moondogs over here. Oh, boy, picks Jeff up. Throws him down on that railing over
there. Throwing right down on top of the security railing. Moondog spot working Lawler over with a trash can. He picks the king up, fires away on him, has the king busted open. Jarrett fires right back off. On spot, spike with Lawler. Outside the ring. Jarrett with a metal chair, comes down off the ring, right down on top of Spot's head. Jarrett wraps the chain around the fist. Fires right off on him. Action everywhere. They're using anything they can get their hands on. Jarrett off the rope, off the ring again with a metal chair. Right down on top of Spot. Lawler up in the ring with Moondog Spike. Lawler tossed into the timekeeper's table head first. The Moondogs. International Roughnecks choking away on the king with a metal chair. Jarrett thrown over the metal security railing outside on the floor.
Boy, he threw Jeff that time. Picked him up and threw him right over that railing. Jeff had the Moondog. Was going to open it to that rail. He reversed Jeff. Hey, look out. Chair over there. Moondog grabs that chair and nails Lawler with it. He's got that chair in the ring now, setting it up on the rope. Grabs Lawler, picks him up. Into that chair that has Moondogs all over it. Moondog spike. Choking Lawler now. Richard Lee at ringside blowing that silly whistle. Oh, Jeff! Came off the rope down the Moondog, but the Moondog caught it back again. Boy, this is a wild out. Lawler and Jarrett versus the Moondog. Mid-South Coliseum, boy, has been turned over. Fans getting behind Lawler now. King back up on his feet.
Both teams continue to get in their shots there, but no real resolution of that match. But this week, it's going to be a different situation.
Oh, no disqualification, no stopping the bout tonight. Mid-South Coliseum, wow.
Going to begin at 7:30.
Yes.
And, boy, what a day we've had today. We hope you'll be joining us next week at the same time. As we leave the air today, as we said, we're going to be leaving with the action there. And we just hope you'll be back with us same time next week. Until then, for Corey Macklin, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
Team situation. Eddie Marlin trying to get the action broke up. They push Eddie out of the way. They have the metal chair. They push Eddie Marlin back again as they double team on Jarrett. Lawler back in the dressing room area. There goes Eddie Marlin down to the canvas.
And we're going to promote Eddie Marlin now. Catch Eddie with that chair. Oh, boy. Moondog rolls referee Frank Morrell. Look at Richard Lee.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.